Lymphedema refers to swelling that generally occurs in the arms or legs caused by a blockage in the lymphatic system. Despite recent medical advancements that address lymphedema, knowledge about this condition is still lacking among the general population. World Lymphedema Day is a patient-driven initiative to make the cure for lymphedema and lymph-related illnesses a global health priority. At MediCircle, we are conducting an exclusive interview on this lymphedema awareness, which is called as Lymphedema Awareness Series, featuring eminent vascular surgeons, physiotherapists, and plastic surgeons treating lymphedema to help raise awareness for all of the people, to help them find knowledge and innovations that support them to be able to live their best lives with lymphedema. Hi, this is Smita Kumar, and today in this initiative, we are going to speak to Dr. Ashok BC. Dr. Ashok is a consultant plastic surgeon at Manipal Hospitals in Bangalore. He has a vast experience of working in the field of plastic, reconstructive, and cosmetic surgery for the last 24 years. He's also an adjunct professor of plastic surgery and co-director of breast surgery fellowship at Manipal University. He has also achieved a fellowship in hand and microsurgery, as well as super microsurgery and lymphatic surgery from Japan. Hello, Dr. Ashok. Welcome to MediCircle.
Good evening, and I'm very happy to be here sharing the screen with you. And it's a good initiative from you guys, and I'm ready to go.
Sure. So to begin with, Dr. Ashok, is lymphedema hereditary? So like it is caused by hereditary, like if your parents are having or if your grandparents are having, there are much more chances that you would be also suffering from lymphedema.
Yes, there is a group of lymphedema called hereditary or congenital lymphedema, which are transmitted from one generation to another. It may be autosomal dominant variety, or it can be sex-linked variety. We call this as Milroy's disease. So yes, in certain kinds of gene expression, there is a hereditary tendency for lymphedema to develop. And these lymphedema occur very early in life and somewhere around 25 to 35 years without any surgical interventions.
Okay. So can lymphedema, suppose like as you said, that a lot of factors depend on what, if it can be carried hereditary or not. Can lymphedema be completely cured? Because there's a myth that it is like it's incurable and it cannot be cured. So what is your view on that?
Yeah, unfortunately, yes, lymphedema cannot be completely cured. We can prevent lymphedema in certain cases. For example, if some person is undergoing axillary node dissection after breast cancer surgery, we can prevent lymphedema from happening by either doing something called a sentinel node biopsy, or we can do something called a primary lymphovenous anastomosis, where after removing the lymph nodes, we can actually reconnect these lymphatic vessels to the available blood vessels in the axilla. And this has shown to reduce the incidence of lymphedema drastically in most of the women who undergo this procedure. So the answer to your question, can it be completely cured? No. The thing is, two ways to look at it. We can prevent it if you get correct treatment at the correct time. And the aim of lymphedema surgeries at this point of time in medical field is to prevent complications, prevent further advancement of the disease, and increase the quality of life of the person who is having this lymphedema.
Okay. So, Dr. Ashok, what is the role of surgery in lymphedema, and can it be cured from it? Because a lot of times patients think that medicine can alone treat this disorder or disease. So can only a surgery like the most important thing to be done if you want to get rid of it or to complete
Till very recently, there was no surgical intervention except removing the whole tissue and skin grafting, which used to be a horrible surgery. But in the last, say, 5, 6, 7 years, there are lots of other options which have been developed. And fortunately, it is even available in Indian medical field as well. What I would say in terms of surgical intervention, as I said, you can, some of them are curative or some of them are preventive. So sentinel node biopsy or primary lymphovenous anastomosis, we can prevent lymphedema from occurring before it gets into the patient at all. And the second set of surgeries, okay, there are two main, as they said, one is vascularized lymph node transfer. Suppose the most common cause of lymphedema other than filariasis in India is post-cancer. After cancer surgery, a person, because they remove lymph nodes to prevent spread of cancer, it leads to secondary problems like lymphedema. Now, such patients, depending upon the stage in which they are, we can either do a lymphovenous anastomosis, that is bypassing those blockages and connecting vein to the lymphatics. So the backlog or the fluid which is accumulated will drain into the veins and it will disappear. Or we can put these lymph nodes from somewhere else in the body, which are functioning, remove them from there, a part of them, so that we don't produce problems there where we take the lymph nodes from, and introduce them into the area where there is problems. So these lymph nodes will act like a sump. They suck in all the lymphatics and put it into the vein. So these two surgeries mainly have actually revolutionized how we look at lymphedema treatment. 10 years back, if somebody came, the only treatment was available was bandage, endless hours of bandaging, yes, and massage. Bandaging and massaging, and when they reach a stage where it is too big, you excise everything and put a skin graft. But these surgeries, the advancement, have really changed how we look at treatment of lymphedema. So yes, there is curative, even though I call them curative, it's not completely curative, but the quality of life the patient will have is excellent after these procedures.
Okay, many a times we give cold compressions to the patients also in case of lymphedema.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Beneficial, and how effective is that?
So we need to look at conservative treatment in terms of three main categories. One, exercise and massaging, compression and cold compression and bandaging and skin care. So all three have their own status in curing or controlling this disease. All three are needed. One alone, any one alone of these three might not be very effective, but in combination, they are really good treatment to do, especially in prevention or in early stage lymphedema.
So one last question, Dr. Ashok, like, can weight loss improve the condition of lymphedema patients?
Yes. There are a lot of studies have shown that lymphedema affects people who have higher BMI. People who have more than 30 BMI, they are more prone to lymphedema, either with surgery or without surgery itself. And to a certain extent, if you lose weight, they reduce, even the lymphedema comes down. But there are some studies which have shown that if the BMI is more than 50, even if they have a weight loss surgery, like a bariatric surgery or something, even when they lose weight after the surgery, the lymphedema doesn't reverse. So yes, early stages of weight loss, it will help you if the weight loss weight of the patient is not too much. But in morbid obesity, the reverse might not be complete or might not happen at all.
So thank you so much, Dr. Ashok. While we were doing this series, even like we were very, it was difficult to get a lot of vascular surgeons on board for this information sharing with the patients out there. So one very quick question, especially for the patients, like if in such a case, like there is the symptoms of lymphedema is there and they are approaching their GPs or doctors, whom should they actually connect with for treatments for lymphedema?
Right now, in Indian scenario, I think plastic surgeons are the ones who are treating lymphedema because they have full repertoire of treatment that is available for them, from microvascular surgery to excision and skin grafting. And there is something called, we do something called indocyanine green fluorescein screening, which really tells us what stage this lymphedema is. And depending upon what stage they are, we can actually propose a treatment for the patient, which is very apt for them. It's like tailor-made treatment for each patient. And anybody who has got an ICG scan facility, that is the place they should go. So it helps, really helps them in treating these patients.
So thank you so much, Dr. Ashok, for joining us our show on lymphedema awareness. I think our audience would also benefit from whatever information you have shared, because a lot of times patients are not sure whom to approach and how to get the symptoms treated or this disease treated. Once again, thanks for joining. All the best for your future endeavors.